Welcome to vlog number 3, and I never thought I would be saying this, well, in self-isolation. Only I could start a YouTube channel about hiking a week before we're no longer allowed to hike. But I'm staying positive. Last night, Boris Johnson said we weren't allowed out. The rules became a lot stricter, so we're allowed out for exercise once a day. I am currently in my local park. It's a 10-minute walk from my house. I spent last night not negative, but really worried, quite upset. I woke up this morning and realised I can't change anything. Oh, sorry, I'm a bit shaky. Realised I can't change anything. I'm going to have to make the most of this. So I'm staying positive. I woke up, I did a to-do list, and I'm going to embrace this time. I'll never get time like this again to work on my blog. I'll never get time like this again to practice vlogs. So let's be productive. It's literally 10 a.m. and I can't believe how beautiful the weather is. Sorry if I'm squinting a bit. I want to be outside all day, every day. And I realise I'm only whinging. This is very much a first world problem. But it's really hard. I don't particularly have any family. I live on my own, so the next however long is going to be a real test for me. But luckily, I have some outdoor spaces I can go to. Sorry, you're at a funny angle, you popped up. So, I've just been speaking to a police officer from 4 metres apart. We shouted across, and she was saying this morning, this is day one of almost complete lockdown, that she's had to disperse groups. She's found groups of dog walkers, groups of people exercising. When she's confronted them, she's just being told, well, that's what we've always done, so that's what we're going to continue to do. And I'll be the first to say, maybe at the start I didn't take it so seriously. The very start, and obviously I do now, I'm doing everything I'm told. I certainly don't want to put anyone else's life in danger, nor my own. But police officers at the moment are having to work solo because there is a crisis happening. So they can't work in pairs. So she's having to confront groups of people that are just blatantly ignoring what they're told, and she's been abused for it. She's been abused 3 times already this morning. And even the police aren't indestructible. We're lucky to have them, but I don't see why they should take any abuse whatsoever because people can't follow the rules. So I've had my exercise. I'm not gonna take the piss with it. I'm grateful that I was able to come out, even if it was just for an hour. But there's a lot of people that live around here and not a lot of space. So if we all don't abuse it, everyone should be able to come out, everyone should get some time outside and not have to worry about bumping into each other. So my plan going forward, I think, is to go out super early, make the most of the mornings when most people are still asleep. For as long as I can, and hopefully we can keep coming out, but I'm not sure. I think I'm going to go home, do some blog work, and maybe try and give TikTok a go. Except for I have even less coordination than I have camera skills, so should be fun going home. So it's now 3:30 of day one of self-isolation, and I've not been productive. I've been on hold for the last 3.5 hours. I really need to speak to my bank. And I know everyone's in the same boat, and I know this is why I'm on hold. But this is what I've been listening to for the last 3.5 hours. It's seeping into my brain. Even when I come off this call, I know I'll be able to hear it. And everything I need to do, I can't do online. And I'm very well aware this is a first world problem. But this music's driving me insane. Insane. That's it. Hopefully I'll do something more interesting later.
Good morning. I am now on day 2 of self-isolation. I'm going absolutely insane. But I've been practicing my videos. I'm feeling really positive. I managed to get outside yesterday. Oh, that's a better height. I'm looking forward to going outside later. However, I'm a massive fan of Instagram. And there are some amazing Instagrams happening at the moment. Some amazing accounts, lots of inspiration. I'm about to climb my stairs 394 times. And once I've done that, it means I've summited Scarfell Pike, which I'm excited about, although I'm not even sure I can do it yet. It's a lot easier to do it when you're outside and you've got amazing views. Pretty sure my neighbours are going to bang on the walls, but I'm going to give it a go. And one of the latest challenges is doing a dip in your wheelie bin. Yep. I've just gone and looked at my wheelie bin and it's pretty disgusting. So I may clean that out this afternoon. I'm easily led. I'll follow a trend. So maybe tomorrow I'll be dipping in my bin. But until then, climbing stairs. I've just done the stairs challenge. I'm absolutely shattered. I think when you're doing an actual mountain, I tend to take my time, tend to enjoy it all. I'll stop for lunch, I'll stop for a drink. I'll just take it all in. When you're doing it on your stairs, it's brutal. I'm absolutely disgusting. I need a shower. I need to lie in the sun. I'm feeling really good though. I'm a long way off getting back to my peak fitness, but every step helps. I've got nothing but time at the moment. Sorry, I'm so out of breath. But I'm really excited. I'm really excited to keep this up. I know the sun's shining and we can't be outside, but even the sun shining and being able to stand in your garden is amazing. It really boosts your mood. I mean, imagine if we were stuck inside and it was absolutely pouring down with rain. Like, how more low would you feel?
And then after my walk, I'm going to fill up my wheelie bin and do a cold water challenge in that. And by I say cold water, it's probably going to be lukewarm because it's bloody freezing. I have just cleaned it out, so I'm just waiting for the sun to go on my garden. Let's not suffer through this. If you can have it in the sun, why wouldn't you? I have lived on my street for 3 years and I'm about midway up the street, and only in the last week have I discovered that at the end of the road, literally the end of the road, there is a Jehovah's Witness centre, a racetrack, tennis courts, and a park. I don't know what I've been doing. I've just discovered this little piece of paradise is right behind where I work, like literally 30 seconds behind where I work. I have never seen it in my life. I'm now getting to the point where I think self-isolation might be a good thing. It's going to teach me some stuff, and maybe I'll come out of it a little bit more observant, and I'll come out of it a lot more thankful for everything we have, and all the relationships I have, all my friendships, relationships with my family. Just feeling a whole lot thankful already, and it's only day 2. I didn't go much further down that path then. It was really muddy and I wasn't expecting to find anything like that around here. So I'm going to come back tomorrow. I'm going to keep its location secret. I'm going to wear better footwear. Currently got white trainers on. So, oh, I'm excited to discover what's down there. I know I think it's the landfill, but I've looked on ViewRanger and there's a couple of water bits. I don't think you can call them lakes. Oh, there's a car. So yeah, that's my plan for tomorrow. I'm trying not to be selfish and not stay out for longer than an hour because everybody needs to be able to come out and enjoy the sunshine.
I am back from my walk. It was lovely. This is making me rethink where I live though. It's not exactly pretty, but I'm not gonna complain. I'm grateful that we can still go out. I am now gonna eat something. My lunch, it's 1 o'clock. And then I'm gonna fill up my wheelie bin for a little dip because it is baking. Why did this not happen in winter?
I am currently filling up my wheelie bin, ready for this afternoon's dip. I cannot actually believe I'm about to do this. I would like to point out that I never watch these clips back unless I think I've sworn or something really bad. But I never watch them and then redo them because that's not life. And I do want to make this as real as possible. So there might be some rambling and it's going to look really rough, as do I currently right now. But it is my life and I am probably the most flawed person I know in the most amazing way. So nothing's really sharp. I don't know if I've got enough footage from bits, but I still need to get on with my life.
Hands up as well if you've adapted to this quicker than you thought you would. Like, I love being outside and I am missing that desperately, but I've adapted to not working pretty quickly, and now I think it's just going to make me more focused on working on my blog and making that a career, because I never want to go back to work and I'm only on day 3. Back at my secret spot from yesterday, in much better shoes for it. Despite it being really hot, still really muddy. I have no idea. Oh, I'm gonna slip. I've got no idea where this path leads, but I'm excited to find out. Still gonna try and stay out for no more than an hour though. So let's hope at the end of it there's a magical oasis.
So I've just discovered this little gem. How beautiful is this? And I was complaining that I lived in a really industrial town, when really, if you know all the hiding spots, there's lots of nature.
I know at the moment it's massively divided opinion about whether anyone should be allowed out, even for one form of exercise a day. But honestly, what this does for my mental health, I can't tell you enough. Not being able to get out would absolutely destroy me. Yeah, I'd be all right for a week, maybe two. But if it does go to 3 or 4 months, there's no way I'd still be happy at the end of it. It would absolutely destroy all the good work I've done on my mental health over the last few years. And I know there are a lot of people out there who feel the same. And I think as long as we're all responsible, like, I've come out, I've not touched anything, I've used dock leaves to open gates, I've not even seen anyone, and I doubt I will, out here. I'm on my own. I'm really still hoping they say we can keep coming out. I've been out for about an hour now, and I am heading back. I'm trying to be good and not stay out too long. So, I'm devastated because this weather is beautiful, and my garden lives in a shadow. But, got my hour, got my fresh air, got my sun. Very happy right now. One of the problems with walking across fields is you always end up further than you thought you would. I've just Google mapped home, and if I stay on the roads, it's an hour's walk. Wasn't expecting that. Oh well, the country lanes, no one's gone past yet. Oh well. Although, alarmingly, there are a lot of men pulled up in their cars, just chilling in lay-bys. Don't know if their wives just kick them out or they just can't take it home anymore. I may have gotten a little bit lost. I found back where I am. I've just been out a bit longer than I thought I would. Luckily, I'm only 20 minutes from home now. I'm hot and I didn't bring any water with me because I didn't think I'd be gone that long. but not complaining.
Hill looking thing in the distance, that is the Peak District. So I can see it, I just can't walk in it.
Day three and I'm now baking cornflake cakes in my garden on my camping stove. Gotta do something to pass the time, I guess.
I also have a little picnic going on in my new lunchbox and pan of water, chocolate over the top. I'm excited for this. And chocolate is nearly melted. There's three family bars in there. As soon as it fully melts, I'm gonna throw some Frosties in it. And then voila, wait for it to set.
Now to mix it. I'm excited by this. I've not made these since I was a kid. Probably still, I don't know if you can see that, probably still use some more cornflakes. Frosties even, so they're going to be super sugary. A few more. I'm pretty sure though, this isn't going to get me my own cooking show.
All done now, I am just going to put it in the fridge and then hopefully eat them later. Okay, melting three bars of chocolate. We'll coat an entire box of Frosties. Didn't know that before. Lesson learnt. Although, I now have enough chocolate cornflake cakes to last me about an hour. So, all's good in the hood.